You know, Crystal, as a minority, and I don't mean it just to typecast here, no, African-American, so forgive me. The African-American community, when polled on this subject, more than 9 out of 10 are for hiking the minimum wage and blame greedy businesses for blocking that kind of thing. How do you sell it to family, friends, people you know, that this is counterproductive for them?
You do what Guy said. You emotionalize this argument. You can't do these studies, this abstract point of view, because black Americans, like every other American, they are worried about putting food on the table, saving for a rainy day. So I think,
explain it to them that denying them that higher wage is going to help.
This is what I think we need to talk about. The unions want you to do this because their membership is sinking and dropping. It's been dropping over the last 10 years. When they want to double the minimum wage, what they're asking you to do and organize and become a member of a union, part of that $15 an hour, you're going to have to give to the big union bosses. You're not even going to see all those wages. But at the same time, black Americans are very aspirational. We've been aspirational since we came to this country. We are literally small business owners and entrepreneurs. So this is the case that you need to make. Do you think, as an American, that anybody, an employer, owes you anything more than a good job and, you know, you get your paycheck every week, you have a good work environment? I think framing it in the debate that you're not owed anything, but with hard work, you get rewarded. And I really think we have to go back to the American dream, talking about what America is about, what Romney failed to do. You and I talked about this during
Absolutely.
The campaign.
No, you're dead on right about that.
And that's what black Americans are very aspirational. They're very oriented around reaching the American dream, but we can't talk down to them. We need to, like Guy said, just, hey, here are the facts. There are not going to be a lot of jobs.
Well, I think you hit on something here, and I want to follow real quickly with you, Guy, that it's why Walmart always gets targeted in these unfair wage stores, because it's not unionized. Other big retailers that pay maybe even less are not. And that's really the dirty little secret here. This is all about unions trying to recruit.
Right.
Correct. And I'm glad you brought up Walmart, because on the front page of the Washington Post today, and I should have brought a copy with me and held it up, there's a huge story about the Walmart's opening here in Washington, D.C. And they announced that for 800 jobs that they've created, there were 23,000 applicants for those jobs.
Incredible.
And those
right.
jobs almost didn't come to Washington, D.C.,
right.
because the city council tried to hike the minimum wage only on Walmart. Walmart said, we can't
Good
afford
point.
That.
Yeah.
And if they had gotten their way, those 800 jobs that 23,000 people wanted would not have existed. And would liberals have declared victory because 800 jobs didn't exist? I mean, that's
well,
the
Well, they do, though, but they do. Ford O'Connell finally on this, and you know, Crystal touched on it with the Romney failings to really articulate this vision. Republicans have to find a way to articulate that without sounding like callous SOBs. How do
Well, that's the problem. Basically, Democrats have been running three plays for the last 7 years and succeeding in that as war on women, despise minorities, and hate the poor. I agree with you. They've got to find a way to break this vicious cycle. Unfortunately, in this global economy, personal responsibility is not out there, and it's very hard to tell people that you have to succeed in schools and you can't have families mm-hmm. until you can afford it. Hopefully, we can find that right tone and do what Crystal said and bring in whether it's white America or black America.
All right.
Black America, and give a 21st century agenda moving forward.
Thank you, guys, very, very much. Crystal, great seeing you again. In the